Hello, my name is Sonakshi Naidu and I'm a research intern at the Internet Freedom Foundation. We're a digital rights advocacy group which seeks to secure your fundamental rights as technology becomes an integral part of every aspect of our life. 24th March 2020 marked 5 years since the Honorable Supreme Court delivered its judgment in Shreya Singhal versus Union of India. This decision is considered as a landmark in internet freedom. Section 66A, which penalizes the sending of offensive messages, was inserted into the Information Technology Act via an amendment in 2008. This amendment took effect from October 2009. Since its insertion, Section 66A was severely criticized on the grounds of being used as a tool to stifle political dissent. Taking notice of the misuse and abuse of the provision, a public interest litigation was filed in November 2012 before the Supreme Court, challenging the constitutional validity of Section 66A. This challenge was based on two main grounds. Firstly, that it was violative of people's freedom of free speech and expression guaranteed under Article 19. And secondly, the provision employed vague and subjective terminology, which permitted law enforcement agencies to mold its definition at their desire and willingness to interpret it. In 2015, Section 66A was declared unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. The court found that Section 66A was vague and arbitrary and could be interpreted to penalize even innocent speech. The effect of this decision would be that all pending cases would be dismissed and that no fresh cases would be instituted under Section 66A. However, a 2018 study by Apar Gupta and Abhinav Sekri highlighted the continuous use of Section 66A, including fresh cases registered in police stations, investigated, and considered by lower courts even after the Shreya Singhal decision. The authors described the continued use of the provision as a legal zombie. In January 2019, People's Union for Civil Liberties, one of the original petitioners in the Shreya Singhal case, approached the High Court, highlighting the study and seeking directions for effective implementation of the court's original direction. The Supreme Court directed that the Shreya Singhal judgment be sent out to all courts in the country, to all senior administrative officers, and the Director Generals of Police. Despite this, fresh cases continue to be invoked as recently as April 2020. In January 2020, the Karnataka High Court imposed costs of Rs 10,000 each on two police officers for registering an FIR under Section 66A of the Information Technology Act. In February 2020, a guest lecturer at a college in Assam was charged under Section 66A, arrested, and later sent to judicial custody. In March 2020, the Patna High Court granted bail to two petitioners who had been in custody for 6 months. These instances highlight the continued use of Section 66A 5 years after it was deemed unconstitutional, despite further directions given by the Supreme Court in 2019. This points to a systematic failure by the judiciary and law enforcement system. The journey of Section 66A highlights the importance and challenges of monitoring and ensuring compliance with the final decisions of the Supreme Court. We are committed to erasing Section 66A from every FIR and criminal case across the country, irrespective of the person who is being prosecuted. Finally, I would like to request you to visit our website on internetfreedom.in and also considering donating to support our work. All the work we do is supported by ordinary Indians like you who donate money to help keep us effective, independent, and serving your fundamental rights. Thank you for watching this video and keep engaging with us on the forum.